plain solution called clay solution. This is very fundamental to subject fault. How faults are classified. And fault plain solution is related to earthquake. That means suppose, as you know, the earthquake happens because of the movement along a fault plane. So when some earthquake happens, it radiates some energy, waves energy, P wave, S waves. So from those S wave and P waves, how can you interpret what types of movement has taken place along the fault plane? It strikes the motion and all that. What type of motion? So these are the two things we will just cover. Now you see, fault classification, you know, this is very basic. You will find in many books like normal fault, reverse fault, and strike slip fault. Now, these faults, what is the criteria to find these faults? You find a trace marker, a bedding plane, trace marker, like bedding plane or bed. You see, if they are upset, then you say it is faulted, and there is a fault. Like if you draw three dimensionally, suppose there is a bedding plane or a bedding like this,
you can draw the same block
So here you say it is a left lateral strike slip. Left lateral strike slip. Left lateral strike slip. Now on the fault plane, you will find the silicon lines. Silicon lines are found in the football block, not on the hanging wall block. Because you cannot see that. You cannot see the hanging wall block, hanging wall face. Hanging wall face also you cannot see. So the silicon lines, if you find in the field, they generally represent the football. So from the orientation of the fault lines, silicon lines, and displacement, you can interpret whether it is a normal fault or a reverse fault or a strike. In case of reverse fault, if the fault plane is very gentle, you know, fault plane is around 45 degree or less, 45 degree or less, you know, 100 degree, 20 degree, you say it is a thrust. You say it is a thrust. So basically, you have normal fault, reverse fault or thrust, and a strike. But these faults, you see, so you have seen, must have seen the faults in the field. So while doing the structural map interpretation, you also come across many faults. So you see, faults can develop. Can develop in a homogeneous rock. Homogeneous rock or a heterogeneous rock. What does it mean? Heterogeneous rock. That means if the rock is homogeneous, homogeneous means no pre-existing, no pre-existing fracture or bedding plane or vein or schistosity, foliation. There is no such features in the rock previous. That is why it's called homogeneous.
So it's difficult to find the offset markups.
No, no. It can develop in a homogeneous rock. How to find it? So you will find the silicon side surfaces. If there is no offset, you will find silicon side surfaces. So you can interpret it as a fault. Or it can develop in a heterogeneous rock. Heterogeneous rock, where already budding planes are there, quartz vein is there, schistosity plane is there. Their offset marks are very clear. Along with the offset, you will get these thicker lines also. So together you can interpret what type of fault it is. But importantly, what we say, you know, if it is a homogeneous rock, and if it is a heterogeneous rock, the development fault is a little different. Different in the what in what sense. You see, as you know, fault develop because of these things. Sigma 1, sigma 2, and sigma 3. Differential stress means the succeed different stress. Sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. Sigma 1 is maximum compression. Sigma 2 is intermediate compression, sigma 3 is least compression. If these three are there, then there will be fault. Ultimately, you need a differential stress. Like sigma 1 and sigma 3 should be very much different. Sigma 2 should be different. Sigma 2 may be equivalent to sigma 1 or equivalent to sigma 3, but sigma 1, sigma 3 should be very much different. Highest one and lowest one. That is why the fault will create. Displacement will happen. If everything is equal, there won't be any displacement.
No deformation also.
No deformation. Suppose you have a block. When I say you deform it, you are pressing. That means you are bringing it into the self stress. Yahan se zyada de raha hai. Other two are less. Folding bhi nahi hoga, kuch nahi hoga. Deformation cannot take place without differential stress. You have to bring a difference, then only deformation will take. So sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 should be there. Now, in case of fault, fault develops in the upper part of the crust, 10 km, 5 km, 6 km like this. They do not develop below 10 km. So the material is becoming ductile. There will be shear zones, folds. So fault will develop in the upper part. You should remember this. Brittle deformation is confined to upper part of the crust. So there, the sigma 1 and sigma 2, sigma 3, you know, one of the stress axis is vertical. Sigma 1 ho, ya sigma 2 ho, sigma 3 ho, vertical ho gai ho. So follow this point now. Because the cross and the air, then it touch. So this surface, you know, this cannot take shear stress. Shear stress. Now think what the meaning of this? Aap dekho, suppose ye half hai, ye half. Ye surface is very dry, slippery nahi. Then इगर आप दोनों तो लड़ाई कर रहे हैं, आप लोग एक के शरीर में भूत तेल लगा दो, दूसरे लोग क्या फाइट कर सकता है क्या? वो स्लिप मारेगा ना, ये ही सही है। इन दोनों पकड़ के रखते हैं आप, तभी जाके फाइट कर सकते हैं ना। यू कैन होल्ड इट एंड फाइट इट। सिमिलरली एयर, यू कैन नॉट होल्ड एयर ओवर द सरफेस, एयर फ्लो करके चले जाएगा। ऐसे समझना आप, मैं जैसे बोला आपको, सो टाउ इज जीरो हियर एलोंग दिस, यहां पे शियर स्ट्रेस नहीं होता है। एज अ रिजल्ट क्या होता है? सो दिस प्लेन, यू नो दिस प्लेन इज ए प्रिंसिपल प्लेन, प्रिंसिपल प्लेन मींस आइदर सिग्मा 1 सिग्मा 2 विल लाइक सिग्मा 2 सिग्मा 3, दिस आर प्रिंसिपल प्लेन्स ना। दिस इज सिग्मा 1 सिग्मा 2 sigma 2 is, sigma 3 is. Plane containing these two is a principal plane of stress. Plane containing these two is a principal plane of stress. So this plane is a plane of principal stresses. This plane of shear stress is not. Understood? Na? The reason is air and solid in contact. See, if it is a plane of principal stress, you know. Then one of the stress axis has to be vertical. Either sigma 1 is vertical, sigma 2, sigma 3 horizontal, or sigma 2 is vertical, this is horizontal, or sigma 3 is vertical, this is horizontal. So that is the fundamentals of fault developments. One of the stress axis has to be vertical. This is Anderson's theory of faulting. So this we are discussing just now. Now you see, so this is a block. sigma 1 is vertical and sigma 2 is horizontal, this is sigma 3 let us say, and sigma 3 2 is horizontal, then you will get conjugate force. Two faults will develop, conjugate fault will develop. Making acute angle with sigma 1. The sigma 1 is an acute angle. So that angle is something around theta is equal to 60 degree. L, maybe 64, maybe 58. If sigma 1 is vertical, sigma 3, sigma 2 horizontal. This is the situation. So this is called dihedral angle.
अगर ये नॉर्मल फॉल्ट है ऊपर तो एयर है तो उसको मैक्सिमम स्ट्रेस क्यों लेते हैं, मैक्सिमम कंप्रेशन क्यों लेते हैं उसको? क्यों लेते हैं हम तो मतलब एक को हॉरिजॉन्टल एक को तो ले सकते हैं मैक्सिमम मैक्सिमम कंप्रेशन, सिग्मा वन को क्यों वर्टिकल रखते हैं क्योंकि ऊपर तो एयर है तो उसका जो ओवरलोडिंग को लेकर
क्यों कैसे सिग्मा वन इधर आ गया, मतलब व्हाट यू आर आस्किंग हाउ ये मैक्सिमम स्ट्रेस कैन बी वर्टिकल व्हेन एयर इज एट द टॉप, दैट इज व्हाट यू आर आस्किंग. हां, दिस इज सब सरफेस, दिस इज नॉट एन सरफेस, इट्स इमीडिएटली सरफेस आल्सो
क्रॉस
सब सरफेस मतलब होगा, इवन सरफेस में भी होगा. क्यों होगा? तो व्हाट इज टेलिंग आप सब तो तीनों थे तो बोले क्रॉस है यहां, यहां, यहां कुछ तो होगा यहां से वर्टिकल, ये जो से 3 किलो वाट, यहां भी 3 किलो वाट, यहां भी 3 किलो, कुछ तो होगा उसका इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक स्ट्रेस. तो व्हाट इज टेलिंग, इंस्टेड ऑफ पुटिंग प्रेशर फ्रॉम द टॉप और स्ट्रेस फ्रॉम द ट्रॉप, यू रिमूव दी स्ट्रेस सो दैट दिस ऑटोमेटिकली बिकम्स बिगर. अंडरस्टूड? यू मे नॉट see the weakest bond in the class, you know, become the strongest bond if the rest of the boys are further weak. So like that, you know.
So basically they are a tensional compression.
For normal fault, you require a tensional. Sigma 3 has to be tensional. That is the point. Understood? So this is the case of the normal fault. So what are they? We find a conjugate fault, two faults. Now, if this is the situation, you will get normal force, conjugate. Now, if aise hota hai, if sigma 3, sigma 1, sigma 2, aise hota hai. In this case, sigma 1 is horizontal. So, sigma 1 is horizontal means the fault will be, acute angle will be facing the sigma 1. And the intersection between these two planes will be sigma 2. And obtuse angle will be sigma 3. That is how. This is Anderson's theory of fault. Anderson's theory of fault. So, what type of fault it will create? This will create thrust or reversal. Thrust or reversal. So somebody may ask for how reversal and sigma 3 vertical. Reversal. Two forces will develop. They are called conjugate forces. Now, if this fault you consider, this block will go. If you consider this fault, this block will go. That is it. Because you are pushing from this side. Now, strike slip fault. What will happen to strike slip fault? case of strike slip fault, sigma 2 is vertical, sigma 1 horizontal and sigma 3 is vertical. But sigma 2 is vertical. In that case, the fault plane will develop again in conjugate fashion. So you can see these faults on the top. Like this dihedral angle will be facing sigma 1. So this is strike slip fault. So when sigma 2 is vertical, it is strike slip. Suppose your Bombay valley fault, you know, we are talking about strike slip. So sigma 2 has to be vertical. Sigma 1 to be compressor horizontal, sigma 3. Now out of these two, which is rational, which is sinister? The compression is from this side. Now. So the arrow will be like this. Because this block has to be pushed in. So this will be sinistral, this will be dextral. One will be sinistral, another will be dextral. This is very fundamental. If you remember these diagrams, three diagrams, many parts of fault problem will be solved. So this angle, the dihedral angle, which is now what is telling you, this happens when the rock is homogeneous. Homogeneous means no other fabric or heterogeneity previously existing there, nothing but purely homogeneous rock. This is a block of granite block. Suppose there are some bedding planes, some sister city planes, hens are there earlier. They are weak planes. They are weak planes. So there, this type of fault will not be created. Faulting will take place along those planes. See, suppose I'll tell you, there are pre-existing planes. Let us take this case. Let us take this case. पहले pre-existing plane था, नहीं है तो then these two planes will develop. This fundamental diagram. But suppose there is a sister-city plane. ऐसे sister-city plane था. So in that case, this historicity plane, see this type of historicity plane, it is close to this plane, theoretical plane. So there will be faulting along this. If there are some pre-existing planes in the rock, what is very close to them, close, then slip will take place along those planes. New fault will not be created. Ye creation hota na ye dono, but this is a pre-existing one, over which slip will take place. Suppose a Bombay valley fault you are talking, it may be a pre-existing plane. Well, because the rock area has undergone deformation many times earlier, there may be some sister-city planes, there may be some fully dicing planes. Like your Ragini and Ambaji area, you are finding number of faults. Who is interested? Or even on your shear zone, there are many cluster faults. So there may be earlier fractures present there during deformation. So when this sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 came, much later. So all those planes, pre-existing planes, along with those planes, slip took place. So this is the difference between a homogeneous rock and a heterogeneous rock. If there are some heterogeneity close to these planes, slip will take place. Over that cycle lines will be there. जैसे सपोज एक ब्लॉक है आपके पास होमोजीनियस, आप इसको तोड़ने के लिए कितना टाइम लगता था? एक फ्रैक्चर है, सपोज रॉक इज ऑलरेडी फ्रैक्चर, जस्ट प्रेस इट इजीली अलोंग दोस प्लेन स्लिप विल टेक प्लेस, फेलियर विल टेक प्लेस. सो दैट इज द फंडामेंटल, समझा ना? नाउ सपोज योर प्री एग्जिस्टिंग प्लेन इज लाइक दिस, ऐसा it is not close to them, the right angle, you see, so sigma 1 the right angle will be, so doesn't make any difference, then the no slip will take place, because it is high angle to sigma 1, so there won't be any fault on these planes, only those planes which are close to this potential surface, then slip will take place, ye nahi hoga. So this is the difference between a homogeneous failure and a heterogeneous failure. Understood, na? Now suppose somebody says the dihedral angle between the fault planes is 60 degree, 62-64, means it is homogeneous rock developed for the first time. But if it is heterogeneous rock, already there are some fractures, some sustricity plane. Plane slip will take place there. What dihedral angle kidhar se aayega? Ek hi plane develop karega. Understood na? What dihedral plane angle nahi aayega? The rock is weak. Understood na? Sometimes you know, I'll come back to that. Similarly, here you see. If it is a homogeneous rock, this condition. But if it is a heterogeneous rock, suppose there are some planes, weak planes were there. Sigma 1 vessel is a. So since it is close to this plane, the thrusting will take place. It need not have create these two planes again. Similarly, in this case, there are some, suppose some are pre-existing. Planes are there. This way, close to this, this way slip karega. This is the difference. Aap suppose in the field you are finding some fault, you cannot apply Andersonian theory there. In this sense, conjugate fault, all these things you may not be able to see. Dihedral angle may not be able to see. Because this may be pre-existing plane, it is a rudra. You know, the road to pass, there are some vertical sustricity planes. Some silicon lines are there. So that means sustricity planes were there earlier. Now there are sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3. So slip took place, creating some silicon lines. Both areas are there. Ambani particularly, Chapri area. Lot of silicon lines, silicon side surfaces are there. The difference between silicon side and silicon lines ka hai. Silicon side is a slip plane, fault plane. Aur silicon lines kya hai? Uske upar jo lines hota hai. Understood na? So this is the difference between these two. Now I'll tell you something. Yeah. इस बार वो उस दिन लड़का मेरे को एक क्वेश्चन दिखाया, वो रियल इंटेलिजेंट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज टेलिंग टू केसेस आर जस्ट आई थिंक इट इज इन जेब, मैं इसलिए किताब को लाया. सपोज draw this block, ना. नाउ मैं एक बेडिंग दिखा रहा हूँ, जो बेडिंग ऐसे डीप कर रहा है, इधर उधर डीप कर रहा है. फिर ये ब्लॉक में कैसा होगा, एक ब्लॉक में इसको पैरेलल होगा, फिर ऐसे डीप करेगा. दो ब्लॉक है, एक बेडिंग प्लेन इज डिपिंग लाइक दैट. स्लिप ये है, स्लिप ये है. अंडरस्टूड ना? सिमिलरली ये एक बेडिंग प्लेन था, देयर कुड बी अनदर बेडिंग प्लेन हियर ना. यहां पे एक बेडिंग होगा, ये बड़ी था, डिप कर रहा है उधर, और थोड़ा सा सबिनेट देखा है, ऐसे बात. पहले ये दोनों अटैच हो गए थे ना, जब बिफोर डिस्प्लेस में ये दो पॉइंट साथ में थे, तो अभी वो स्ट्राइक स्लिप हो गया ऐसा. तो एक बात क्या हो गया, ये पॉइंट इधर चला गया, ये पॉइंट इधर चला गया, बट बेड का डीप है इधर. समझ गया ना क्या है, ये इंक्लाइन बेड व्हिच हैज बीन faulted by strike slip fault. Now, yes, yes, like this, there are so many faults. यहाँ भी एक होगा जो dip करता है. ठीक है ना? तो ये block यहाँ कहाँ दिख रहा है? ये bedding कहाँ दिख रहा है इधर?
ऊपर थोड़े.
इधर दिख रहा है. ऐसे दिखेगा नेचुरल. स्ट्राइक स्लिप फॉल्ट हुआ. ठीक है ना? व्हाट इज टेलिंग, मैं इसको इग्नोर कर गया, ये ब्लॉक इधर है ऐसे. व्हाट इज टेलिंग इवन दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट, दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट, दिस व्हाटएवर यू आर सीइंग कैन हैपन उन उन सा केस. सी दिस इज योर डिस्प्लेसमेंट, यू आर टेलिंग दैट टू स्ट्राइक स्ट्राइक स्लिप, बट इट कैन आल्सो हैपन बाय सम अदर फॉल्टिंग. ऐसे सपोज द बेडिंग प्लेन इज डिपिंग लाइक दिस एंड ऑन द सरफेस यू आर सीइंग अ ऑफसेट, यू आर टेलिंग दिस इज स्ट्राइक स्लिप फॉल्ट, फाइन, नो प्रॉब्लम. बट कैन इट आल्सो हैपन इफ दिस ब्लॉक गोज अप थ्रस्टिंगली. बात ये है, ये जो ब्लॉक आप ऐसे कर दिया ऐसा, सो नेचुरली देयर विल बी डिस्प्लेसमेंट लाइक दिस. बट इंस्टेड सपोज ये दोनों साथ में थे, ये दोनों साथ में थे पहले, आप ये ब्लॉक को ऊपर ले जाओ, ऊपर ले जाओ, ये ब्लॉक को सब ऊपर उठा लो, तो फिर काट दो. ये जो प्रोजेक्शन था इधर ही प्रोजेक्शन जो ऊपर आता था लिफ्टिंग दैट साइड ना जो ऊपर उठा लिया ऐसा ये पॉइंट ऊपर चला गया तो ये शिफ्ट हो जाएगा ये दिस कैन आल्सो हैपन इन केस ऑफ थ्रस्ट फोल्डिंग यस सो ये सब थोड़ा आपको हैपन ओपन योर आई वेरी क्रिटिकल वेरी डिफिकल्ट इन द फील्ड टू say whether it is right click or a thrust. Similar displacement will take place. So in that case, you have to see this section. This section you have to see. If there is a thrust like this, you know, initially they were like this. Now this block will go up. So thrusting will be shown. On this side, thrusting will be shown. ऐसे करके इनको इंटरप्रेट अंडरस्टूड दिस पैटर्न थोड़ा समटाइम्स यू नो यू शुड सी बिलिंग को इंडिविजुअल फिगर्स वेरी बेसिक बीएससी लेवल बट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स ही हैज टोल्ड दिस वाज अ क्वेश्चन इन जैम दिस टाइम गेट वे का आता है गेट वे में इससे इजी क्वेश्चन आता है बट पीपल डू मिस्टेक बिकॉज दे डोंट रीड दिस पैटर्न ये सो क्लास में दे शुड कवर क्लास में इंडिविजुअल ब्लॉक दे शुड कवर In field pe suppose you found some bed is displaced like this. Aise displaced okay. Immediately don't take it in dextral system. You should not take it. It could be thrust also. It depends how the conveyor is hitting. And fault can strikes. So all these things matters. Understood na? Okay. Now, one more example I'll give you. That also I think it came in the gate paper, you know. Gate paper. What type of fault it is? Oblique. Strike slip what is this fault should have been here. I mean that. Deep slip what is this one would have come here. This is an oblique fault like this. Slip is this one. This is the slip. This is the slip. On the fault plane, the silicon lines will be like this. Like this. Because lines will develop like this. Understood what I'm telling you? Now, what he is telling you now? What he is telling? He is showing a bedding plane here. This is the slip line. A bedding plane goes like that. Parallel to slip. A bedding parallel to slip. ऐसे तो बेडिंग का डीप जो है ट्रेस ऑफ द बेडिंग ऑन द फॉल्ट प्लेन इज पैरेलल टू द नेट स्लिप यही है ना द ट्रेस ऑफ द बेडिंग द ट्रेस ऑफ द बेडिंग इज पैरेलल टू नेट स्लिप इसके साथ पैरेलल You understand, sir? If you observe both the blocks, a block diagram is put before you, then you can say the oblique slip part. But now, in the field, you will not get a block diagram. Either you see the surface or the vertical section. In the field, either you see it on the surface or a vertical section. So, what type of slip do you show? Now, you see, suppose. Vertical section. Let us draw a vertical section. A vertical section means it's a cardboard, erosion proof. क्यूबॉइड की भी पोजीशन अंदर वर्टिकल सेक्शन, ऐसे आप काट देंगे, ऐसे काट दिया तो देन दिस पॉइंट एंड दिस पॉइंट विल बी टुगेदर ना, आप इसे काट के जाओ तो इट विल गो टू दिस पॉइंट, गो टू दिस पॉइंट, गो टू दिस पॉइंट, देन इट विल गो टू दिस पॉइंट. सो इफ यू डू ए वर्टिकल सेक्शन इसके जो वर्टिकल एग्जैक्टली ऑन द सरफेस इज कॉल्ड एपिसेंटर. दिस इज हाइपोसेंटर. दिस इज योर द सरफेस इज एपिसेंटर वर्टिकली ऑन द सरफेस. वर्टिकली ऑन द सरफेस ये है आपका न्यूक्लियस फोकस. Understood, na? Similarly, strike slip fault, or thrust fault. Now, when this sort of faulting takes place, this radiates, you know, yahan se. You may have heard S waves. So, there are many size programs sitting in earthquake prone areas. अपना मोल सा बेटा है कभी नहीं गया देखने के लिए बट जरा भी घूम कर नहीं है बिकॉज कॉन्स्टेंटली हैव रेकॉर्ड. कॉन्स्टेंटली हैव रेकॉर्ड. सो ऑनलेस यू रेकॉर्ड इट यू कैनॉट इंटरप्रिट बिकॉज नाइट टाइम सपोज आफ्टर हैपन एंड योर पीपल आर नॉट देयर बट देयर शुड बी मिसिंग व्हिच इज रिकॉर्डिंग डाटा. व्हिच डाटा? Now this Q wave and S wave are discovered. Now out of these two waves, you know, the P wave is most important. P wave is the most important. P wave is most important. For understanding what type of movement has taken place. Is a normal slip, strike fault, a strike slip fault, or reverse slip fault. P wave. Then, suppose you have some earthquakes, the P wave is radiating all sides. Now, there are no machines, you know, I am just drawing. There are no machines. This is earth surface. Yeah. Earthquake. So, this is radiating P waves. So there will be machines you know, surrounding this. So here it's a core, this is the epicenter. There will be machines surrounding. Good coil, but you have to handle the machine, the other one, the other one. And each of the circles have a machine, but higher, outside or building. I think he is recording something else. Most of is recording something else in whose area? Rajasthan area. Or Bhavar, near Bhavar. He has some machines there. You can talk to Rajesh. So these machines, you know, seismographs, they record those P waves. First P wave. First P wave motion analysis. पहले तो P wave आप पहुंचता है. Understood ना? P wave first motion analysis. P wave, fast motion analysis. Fast motion analysis. पहले तो P wave आके पहुंचता है उसको पकड़ते हैं. So this fast wave जो आता है this could be compressional or dilational. Compressional or dilational. It will show the P wave which is coming is compressional. What is the compressional dilation? I'll explain. Generally, you understand. P waves are longitudinal waves, you know. A waves are transverse waves. P waves move karta hai. Longitudinal waves. Parallel to directional propagation. Understood, na? So, two aapne hi sikhaye. Earthquake form. Ye aapka P wave hai. If it is compressional, marega hai. If it is dilational, isko khinch lega. So depending on what type of motion it is, first motion. पहले वो क्या create कर रहा है? This collision and this effect will be different. Suppose यहाँ से vibration हुआ, the first one will push outside, it will push कर दे. तो this P wave will strike against it. ये इसका ऐसे चीज है, जो खींच लिया, तो ये dilation होगा. तो first motion will be here there is a compressional wave or a directional wave. So depends on what it is propagating in this direction. Understood? कभी कभी आप ट्रेन में जाने का टाइम नहीं, कभी आप बहुत भीड़ है, आप खड़े हैं यहाँ, सारे तो लोग बाग खड़े हैं, आप एक पुश कर दिया, so you will realize that you are pushing, but यहाँ जो आदमी खड़ा है वो बोलेगा मारे, तो खाली देश बोल रहे हो, तो आप मुंह हो गया ना, तो यह जगह हो गया ना, इस पार्ट में इस मैप में realize dilation, this part में आपको realize compression. You understand the compression and dilation. वो झटका से क्या होता है? What impact it produces on the surrounding? ये compression झटका और dilation झटका. समझा? हाँ. तो वो क्या होता है ऐसा आपके? आप suppose that the normal fault ना? First draw करते हैं normal fault. ऐसे normal fault होता है ऐसा? ऐसे slip करता है normal fault. Understand this diagram? So that means this block goes down, the footwall goes up. Normal fault we are discussing, yeah? Normal fault. Normal fault. Understood? Now this fault, आप देखो, ये आठ क्रॉस के नीचे है, क्रॉस के नीचे. You can draw a ellipse like this na, you see the arrow dekh ke ellipse kar sakte hain, straight ellipse from the arrow. Now what will happen if the ellipse becomes like this? This is the fault plane. You have to draw another 90 degree plane to it. Yes sir. Yes. ऐसे फॉल्ट प्लेन था, अब देखो ऐसे फॉल्ट प्लेन था, इसका ऊपर ऐसे 90 डिग्री प्लेन है, इसको बोलते हैं कौन सा प्लेन? नोडल प्लेन. दिस इज द फॉल्ट प्लेन, दिस इज द नोडल प्लेन. देखो आप मैं ड्रॉ करके रखा, तो स्लिप इधर ऐसे हो रहा है, स्लिप इधर ऐसे हो रहा है. नाउ अभी देखो देयर आर फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स, nodal plane and fault plane together they are making four quadrants. 1 2 3 4 samjha na, main usko thoda draw karta hu in this manner. Kaise ye fault plane hai, ye nodal plane hai, ye fault hai, ye nodal. Apna movement direction aisa hai, theek hai. Now इसके एलिप्स कैसा है? एलिप्स ऐसा है, एलिप्स ऐसा है, ठीक है. Now आर सरफेस इज दिस, आर सरफेस इज दिस, ये फॉल्ट प्लेन है, नोडल प्लेन है. तो ये एरिया में आप एक साइसोग्राम बैठा हो, यहाँ एक साइसोग्राम है, आप यहाँ पे एक साइसोग्राम डाल सकते हैं, इधर यहाँ पे एक साइसोग्राम डाल सकते हैं, डिफरेंट एरिया साइसोग्राम. ये एरिया में जो साइसोग्राम है, दिस विल रिसीव यू फर्स्ट क्यू वेव आइदर कंप्रेशन और डायलेशन. इधर ये दूसरा करेगा, ये दूसरा करेगा. नाउ ये पार्ट में क्या होगा, आप एलिप्स देखो, एलिप्स देखो, यहाँ क्या होगा? तो ये मटेरियल को क्यों ले जाते हैं? ये मटेरियल को ऐसे पुश करता है, ट्रेन में आप खड़े हैं, इसको पुश कर दिया, ट्रेन में खड़ा है, ये जगह खुल गया. ऐसे सोचो, ये एलिप्स तो ऐसे प्रेसिंग से बनता है, लेकिन जो मटेरियल है वो कैसे फील करता है? कुछ मटेरियल इसके तरफ चला गया, तो ये रिलैक्स हो गया, ये रिलैक्स हो गया. इधर यहाँ क्या कुछ मटेरियल यू हैव रिमूव दिस वे, वो स्ट्रेचिंग हो जाते हैं ना, कुछ मटेरियल यहाँ पुश करते हैं. तो ये सब फैक्टर कंप्रेशनल हो जाएंगे, ये डायलेशनल हो जाएंगे. दिस इज हाउ इट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. understood na? Kyun yahan balance na hota hai? See this tail ellipse, ye aise khinch lega isko, press nahi kar raha. You are not thinking about this point, you are thinking about this point. यहाँ कैसे रियलाइज नहीं होता? वो देखो आप तो ट्रेन में खड़े हैं, इसको पुश कर दिया, उसका पर क्या असर होता है आप देखो, आपका पर नहीं, वो प्रेस हो जाएगा कि नहीं प्रेस हो जाएगा, आप इसको पुश कर दे कंप्रेशन हो जाएगा कि नहीं होगा, यहाँ आदमी क्या होगा रिलैक्स हो जाएगा, डायलेशन हो जाएगा, आपका पर क्या नहीं, ये तो इसका शॉर्ट फॉर्म में वो लिखता है डायलेशन को क्या लगता है पी देता है ना एक पी स्टैंड्स फॉर डायलेशन पी स्टैंड्स फॉर डायलेशन पी स्टैंड्स फॉर कंप्रेशन ऐसे कुछ वो एज्यूम किया है ये अंडरस्टूड ना दिस डिस्क्रिप्शंस देन द रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स इज नो प्रॉब्लम हाउ दिस Dilation and compression are appearing. Now then, that machine, you know, to produce a steady unit. Automatically. Once the output happens, this come out. Now, patak se ho internet ke class mein. Now, ye kaise hoga? The fault plane will be like this. This is a fault plane. A nodal plane is 90 degrees. This is nodal plane. This is fault plane. Fault plane is dipping that side. Nodal plane is dipping this side. So there, top part, the dilation part. So this is dilation. Or it starts from P and these two sides compression or tension jo bhi hai C starts for T T erode then he is giving a symbol you know usko dark de deta hai usko dark kar deta hai dark Dilation symbol is P, index is vacant. Compression symbol is C, S is P, but that is A symbol. So, understood na this part now let us go to a thrust mein kya hota so I am not drawing this part again I will only draw this part thrust mein this is fault this is the nodal plane The movement direction is like this, opposite to here. This is thrust. This is normal fault. Normal fault. This is thrust. Now you decide whether what type of sector it is or what type of segment it is. How is the strain ellipse? Strain ellipse will be like this. Then the ellipse will be like this. Your arrows are like this. So, in this sector, what happened? Materials are coming towards. So, this will be dilation. And this will be compression. This will be compression. D stands for dilation, C stands for compression. So, D means aapka P ho gaya hai, P. T means P A हो गया, T means open, T means close, so cellulite कैसे आएगा? So this is your thrust, this is your nodal plane, this is fault, this is nodal plane. So center wall will be C. C for your dark, ये dark हो जाएगा. ये open रहेगा. This is T, this is P. तो उल्टा हो जाएगा. It is thrust movement. So what USGS say? They have machines everywhere, all over the world. So the machine you know immediately tell compressor and tensor. Which one is compressor wave, which one directional wave? Immediately it will produce a graph like this, telemetry like this, and says this is a thrust fault. This is a normal fault. They ask you to split between this. Similarly, go to strike slip fault. Kumar, can I just add this one? I can come?
Yes.
Huh? Here also you can come, huh? Strike slip fault. In case of strike slip fault, this is on the surface. Fault. This is nodal plane. This is on surface. These are sections. These are sections. These are map. This is map. This is section. So the map it will produce a picture like this, you know. You can map your seal. This is fault. This is nodal plane. So in these two quadrants, it is like this. So this is directional, this is compressional, so this is directional, this is compressional. So compressional fields are darker. Yes. So strike slip fault will have intersection at the center. We are seeing from the surface. Those are profile. So these will be central one, if it is dark, it is thrust. Central one, if it is open, it is a normal fault. If they are equally divided, it is strike slip. So like this they interpret. This is not PUA fast motion analysis.
So this is same as Biswal method? Biswal method is same
as
Biswal method.
Biswal methods, yes, yes. Same as see, number of maps are produced, you know. This is very old map, like this. So from each diagram, this is a thrust, this is a strike slip, this is a strike slip. We can say this group here, strike slip movement is taking place, the thrust is taking place. From there is an arc wave, this type of diagram is generated. Understood, na? So this is called PUA, fast motion analysis. So what we will do, we will stop it here. Okay, na? Okay.